even a few years ago, we had a lobby in Barbados say that even Haiti was doing better than Barbados. That Haiti was growing and Barbados was not growing. Look what Barbados come to. We heard that in Barbados. Because you have a motley collection of well-organized self-seekers who are determined to tear Barbados down. And let me tell you something. I'm not saying they can't succeed, but they're not going to succeed as long as I am at the control. I hear them. But they have all them under surveillance. Because there is some studied attempts to destabilize this country. And make it ungovernable. For the last 5 years in particular, every effort was made to get Barbadians to believe that they should get rid of the government they freely and fairly elected in 2013 in the month of February. There were even dark hints, and I know what I'm talking about. There were even dark hints that if the government had to be brought down by force, so be it. From people that we would have regarded otherwise as responsible.
That's right.
But I kept my peace. Because you heard me say this over and over and over again. In peace, there's nothing so becomes a man as modest stillness and humility. But when the blast of war blows in his ears, then he must imitate the action of the tiger. He must stiffen his sinews and summon up his blood and disguise his fair nature with a harsh, fevered rage. He must lend his eyes a terrible aspect. I kept quiet. But as I said before, the blast of war is now being heard in my ears. And we are going to see who is who. But I feel very proud to have led a government that has achieved what we were able to achieve over the last 10 years in Barbados. 2 years and 9 months of Prime Minister Thompson, the remainder of mine. Our record in the area of housing continues to be an enviable record. Our record in the area of labor cannot be equaled by any politician in Barbados, or has not been equaled by any politician in Barbados over the last 50 years. Thanks to Dr. Esteban. No! Richard Seeley, Minister Richard Seeley, saw the tourism graph point downward as that financial crisis that took hold of the world in the last quarter of 2007 began to affect the tourism sector. We saw the graph point downward. And he took, like a man, all of the criticisms that came his way while that reality existed. But he was not a man to run away. So he stuck with it. And the graph now points upward to record after record after record. Our opponents can't take it. They can't take it. We are stuck like a fishbone across their throats. They can't take it. And that is why, when Parliament is dissolved, and a date for general election is set. We are going out into the highways and the byways and the hedges, and we are going to, we have not come to call the righteous, we've come to call sinners to repentance. We're going to bring them in and ensure that we are able to continue the work upon which we have embarked ever since January 2008.